Now it's time for us to start drawing in Storyboard Pro, and the simplest way to do that is to come over here to the toolbar and select the brush tool. Then go over to Tool Properties, pick one of these brush presets, and then adjust the size as needed. Come over and pick a layer to draw on, and then just start drawing. This little guy with the very big nose is named Lenny, and he's going to be the star of our little storyboard project that we're working on. Now, up to this point, the only tool I've been using to draw is the brush tool. Now that I've gotten to this point, there are a few other tools that I'm going to use in the drawing process, and let me show you those now. One of the other drawing tools that I use frequently is the eraser tool, which is right down there, and if you click on that and come to Tool Properties, you'll see that you have a lot of options, just like we did with the brush tool. And with the eraser, it works just like a brush, except for backwards. So I could take this eraser and just erase part of my drawing. And I can also make the eraser much bigger by sliding it, which lets me erase larger portions at a time. Maybe the most important tool that I use in the drawing process is the selection tool. And that's the black arrow here up at the top. This is something that we use for just about everything in Storyboard Pro. It looks like a lasso, and if you use the selection tool and put it around, drag it around the object that you want to work with, then you can move the object. When you see the crosshairs appear, you can click and drag and move that object anywhere. You can also scale the object and stretch it by pulling on various controls here. If you press down shift and drag from the corners, you can scale it in perfect proportion. An example of using the selection tool would be to select that pupil, for example, and then just drag it over if I wanted to change the eye direction or stretch it or do any number of different things like that. To make sure that object gets deselected, just click anywhere on your drawing area or press the escape key. Using the selection tool will let you also change the color of a line. Now that I've selected this line, I can go over to the color palette and click a different color. And when I do, that line has changed to another color. Now I'll change it back to black by clicking on the black and then deselect it by tapping on the drawing area. The other really helpful tool that I use while drawing is the cutter tool. And if you click on the toolbar where the selection tool is, and if you hold, then you can drag down and select the cutter tool. The cutter, when you're using it, looks a lot like the selection tool. It has a lasso, but now you can select just a portion of the line and you can delete it by pressing delete, or you can move it the same way that we moved the line before. When you hover over the line and you get those crosshairs, you can click and drag and move that anywhere that you want to. You can resize it and do all the other things that we did with the selection tool, except here you get to use just a portion of the line that you want to use.